Joy to the world! The Lord has come. Happy Christmas! Look at my lovely little penguin Christmas mug. Yes, Frosty's with me. And here we are, and we are going and wishing all of you who've been journeying with me through this on cupán tay and with me on this on cupán tay a very happy and joyous Christmas. Oh, what? Joyous? What does that mean? You know, joy to the world, the Lord has come, let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. Why? Why do we need them to sing? Is that not the question? Of course it's the question. What is this joy anyway?
Oh, Nigel, don't you know? It's because Jesus Christ was born over 2,000 years ago, and that should fill your heart with joy, Nigel.
Oh, really? But what is joy? Well, I have to go check it up and discover what it means in the Greek. And I thought it was interesting. Chara is the word for joy. And what it means is gladness of heart. I love that. Gladness of heart. Ooh. Now, you see, that makes it real personal, don't it? Oh, yes. We're not speaking about downhearted. I'm not speaking about having a crushed heart. I'm not speaking about being broken-hearted. Oh, no. We're speaking about the gladness of heart. Very rarely would you go and mention about someone, oh, I was talking to so-and-so, you know, they're suffering from gladness of heart. No, we would talk, oh, I found so-and-so, and he was very downhearted now. He's very downhearted. He was, oh, I'll tell you now, tis tough what he's going through. He's very downhearted. So he is. That's the sort of stuff that we talk about. Rarely, if ever, do we ever talk about gladness of heart. My goodness. You know, I was talking to him, and he's got gladness of heart, he has. But that's what joy means, is a gladness of our heart. But why? What is that based on? That is the question, this gladness of heart. And that brings me to Romans and chapter 15 and verse 13. Which one of the favorite little verses I have? I love it. It's a beautiful little blessing. A beautiful little prayer of Paul in the book of Romans to the Roman people. And of course, to you and me. And it goes and says, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that your hearts may overflow with hope through the power of the Holy Spirit. Ooh, I love that. But notice what's happening. God is filling our hearts with joy. Now, how does God fill our heart with joy? Is that not a big question? And at this time of the year, when we're speaking about joy and the fact that Jesus came, well, what does that mean to you and me? How does that impact our lives? Well, here's the thing. Joy to the world, the Lord has come. So how does that bring me joy? Is that not a fair question to ask? How does that bring you joy? In the midst of everything that's going on, how did Christ coming bring us joy? Well, here are four things that I want to share with you. I thought, as I dug into this, it's very exciting. The first thing is that God is our refuge. This is what it goes and says in Psalm 5 and 11. But let all who take refuge in you rejoice. Let them ever sing for joy. Spread your protection over them, that those who love your name may rejoice in you. See that? The psalmist is saying, let them ever sing for joy. We should be the happiest people on the planet, knowing the fact that God is our refuge and strength. God is the one who's protecting us. That our lives right now are hidden with Christ in God. Woo, that is so exciting. Does that not fill you with joy? Do you know the reality of that, maybe? Maybe you don't know the reality of that, but it doesn't stop there. The second thing, of course, is that he's Emmanuel. He is God with us. Listen to what it goes and says. You make known to me the path of life. Who is life? Jesus. Who is the path? Jesus. You have made known to me the path of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence. So when Christ came to earth, here was God with us. We are now in his presence. So that's what are we looking at? One, that he is our refuge. Two, that we are in his presence. He is with us. Three, that he ministers to us. And how does he do that? He ministers to us through his word. If you want to know just how much God loves you and cares for you, guess what? Pull out this book and read it. And you will discover just how much God loves his people. Oh, what does it go and say? It says, the precepts of the Lord are right, giving joy to the heart. In other words, God's word, God's ways, God's laws, God's statutes, God's precepts give joy to the heart because they are right. The commands of the Lord are radiant, giving light to the eyes. So have you met someone and they've been in the Word of God and they're just like, woo! They are just so full of life and enthusiasm and joy because of His Word. The fourth reason that I said I was going to give you is because God blesses you. God blesses you in your workplace. God blesses the work of your hands. God blesses you with your pay pack. God blesses you with all of those things, because that's your harvest, by the way. And here's what it goes and says in Deuteronomy and chapter 16 and verse 15. For the Lord your God will bless you in all your harvest, i.e. that's when you bring home your pay pack in our world, and in all the work of your hands. Look, God's blessing the work of your hands, and your joy will be complete. Now, how often do you get up and you go, "Whoa, I am so excited about going to work today." No, the problem is that we lose fact that God is actually blessing us with the opportunity to go and work. God is blessing us with the opportunity to be able to actually go and make money through our hands. God is blessing us in all of these areas. So, how is it? Just let's recap on this. What is joy? Joy is gladness of heart. So, this Christmas season, when we celebrate the fact that Jesus came into the world, He is the one who brings joy to our lives. And here's how He does it. Number one, He is our refuge. Number two, He is the one who is with us, Emmanuel, God with us. Number three, that He is the one who goes and ministers and speaks to us through His word. He goes and says, heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will never pass away. It's eternal. We can trust in it. We can bank on it. So He ministers to us through His word. And number four, He is blessing you in the activities that you're about this day. God is good. And so that is why we have reason to rejoice. Now, in that first verse, it goes and says this, let every heart prepare him room. If you don't know the joy that I'm speaking about that comes at Christmas this time, here's why. Maybe you need to make room for Jesus. And that brings us to the place, and I love this, in Revelation 3:20, where it goes and says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone opens the door, I will enter in and I will sup or eat with him and he with me. Jesus Christ wants to come in and have fellowship with you. Now this Christmas, have you got room to have fellowship with him? That is a question. Because if you do, then the joy I'm speaking about will truly be the joy that you will know. Have a wonderful, joyous, and blessed Christmas. And thank you for joining with me throughout the whole of 2023 for our cupán. God bless you.